So I got this wee French yogurt simply because I liked the cute little glass jars that it came in. And I'm going to sample it now. And I would like, so today it's noon. I have to work tonight, so I should be sleeping, but everything in my house is such a mess right now. Just kind of give you an idea of how tore up everything is. Dishes everywhere. Yeah, I got lots to do. Like my bedhead, I think I'm gonna just like make this my regular look. Like I'm just gonna give up on my hair. I'm gonna wash it and comb it, and then whatever direction it goes in or however it goes is like what it's gonna be. But now I'm gonna try this wee French yogurt and see what it tastes like. Taste testing time on the YouTubes. Okay, so it tastes kind of like the custard style Yoplait yogurt, but a little bit better. It's like different, but not by much. I don't know. Whatever. It's good. I like it. I'm gonna eat it. Loaded with sugar. I don't know. Not as bad as I thought. It's got like 15 grams of sugar compared to like the 30 that's in a regular thing of Yoplait, but I don't know. I got it because I like the jar. Great reason to buy stuff, right? I'm gonna keep the jar and use it for other things, but yeah, I like it. It's a winner. I don't know, in my head I sound like, I know I'm tired, so I guess I sound like I'm tired, but in my brain I sound very unenthused, but I'm actually not. I'm actually kind of enthusiastic about this wee yogurt right now. Oh, I look lovely. I just worked out. Do I look fitter, healthier? Smaller? I don't think so. I'm taking a look. Nope. So just a little, whoa, just a little perspective. Oh, I love my hair. I love it. I love it. I want to keep it this way forever. But just a little perspective on, okay, so since 2015, I've lost about 120 pounds. Like, and for the last year and a half, year or so, I've maintained the current weight that I am, but I still want to get down like 20 pounds more. I actually have a lot of like really gross and ugly loose hanging skin that probably weighs about 15 pounds to where if I got it removed, it would get me close to my goal. But I'm trying to lose more weight because getting the skin removed is, I'm never going to be able to afford that. Like it would be nice, but I'm just never going to be able to afford that kind of money. But yeah, so a little out of breath, which is a good thing. Right now I'm doing this Jillian Michaels Gauntlet, which is like a year long program. And it's pretty awesome. I like it. I do play like TV and stuff in the background, and I do run the workout on my iPad because I like the distraction, so it takes my mind off of like how tired I'm getting or how much an exercise hurts and how long the workout is taking. What's your school of thought on that? Some people say that having distractions like makes you not work out as hard. Others say that having the distraction helps you keep going and you're not really noticing how it feels. I'm kind of in that school of thought, but I'm just curious. Tell me what you think. Like, I'd like to know. But, like, back to, I have an outfit left over from not my biggest days, but from, like, because, okay, so the outfit that I have that I kept from before I started losing weight was about, I wore that when I was about 20 pounds less than the heaviest I've ever been. So when you're that big, like when you're as many sizes up as I was, it doesn't really matter. But I'll try to dig it out, and like tonight I'll put it on and I'll show you guys like the difference, because I don't know, like to me sometimes like I don't see the difference because I just sometimes in my mind's eye I still see myself as that big person, and I wonder if that's like a common thing with other people who have lost a significant amount of weight, if they still look at like a space between people or like tiny, tiny little bathroom stalls, and in the back of their mind, they're like, well, I better avoid that because it's gonna be a tight squeeze, or I'm not gonna fit, or I'm gonna brush against somebody. But in reality, you're gonna fit through perfectly fine because you're not this big person anymore, but you don't realize you're not this big person anymore. So like, I don't know. So like this t-shirt that I'm wearing, like I got it at Universal Studios because it said no carbs on it, and a Dr. Seuss t-shirt, and I thought it was awesome because at the time, like one of the ways that I was losing weight was I wasn't eating any carbs, and I really need to get back into low carb eating so that I can lose the rest of the weight that I want to lose. But like this t-shirt is it's a large. Shirts at Universal tend to run kind of small, even the men's and the unisex ones, but it's a unisex large. And I don't know, it fits me like this now. And I don't know, I feel like even though it's a little baggy, that it still essentially fits. Like I wear it around the house and stuff, and sometimes I'll wear it out depending on if I'm dressing down. I mean, I don't know. And then the other was on the like, inside. You tell me how baggy. I can't like show it because I have the camera in my hand and I can't, you know, reach down. Whatever, it's hard. But so when I got this shirt, it was after I had already started losing weight, but not like too far in, and it was a large, and at the time I was wearing like a 2X, and depending, like 2X in men's shirts, and I couldn't fit in anything for women at all. Like it was just ha ha ha, unless it was from like Lane Bryant or a plus size store or just like a big giant ugly Hanes t-shirt. Like I didn't fit in anything women's, and I couldn't afford the expensive, like they have nice clothes for big women at like Lane Bryant and stuff like that, but or Torrid, but I really couldn't afford it, you know, for, so I didn't wear them. And even then I still was uncomfortable in everything I put on. I didn't think I looked good in anything. But anyway, so this shirt's a large, it's baggy on me now, but when I bought it, I had already lost probably about 50 pounds, but I couldn't even get it on. Like, so it was a goal shirt, and now it fits like this. But I realize I still want to go down a little bit more. Like, I don't want to lose too much weight, but because I can't get the skin removed that I need to get removed to make me the size I want, I feel like I need to, like, lose the weight to get to the size I want to be. I don't know. Tell me what you think. If you've lost a significant amount of weight, or if you know somebody who's lost a significant amount of weight, and you understand, like, the struggles that go with this whole process of not feeling pretty still and the whole 9 years, I don't know. I look like heck right now, but you know, this is a vlog. It's like a diary. So I'm telling my diary and you know what's going on in my life right now. And the beautiful thing about a vlog is that sometimes your diary can talk back to you and tell you what they think. So yeah, later on I'll try to dig out that outfit and I'll show you what I look like now and see how it translates on film. Yay, so Courtney's home. So this is the outfit that I was talking about earlier that I saved before I started to lose weight. It's not my, put a nice underwear shot in there. It's not the biggest outfit that I ever had because like I said, that this outfit was from about 20, 25 pounds smaller than my heaviest weight. But I don't know, when I look at myself in the mirror, I feel like it's baggy, but not like, obviously I wouldn't be able to wear it, it's too big, but I feel like it's not like super dramatic, you know? But I don't know. I feel like the difference between me then and me now isn't that dramatic, especially like this tank top was like stretched tight when I would wear it before. Yeah. And then this would just, it wouldn't be loose. It would actually fit like, you know, around it. And then of course the shorts, but I don't know. This is the one outfit that I kept to like remember my bigger days. And I don't know, but this is what I was talking about. And I said I was going to show you. And earlier question that I asked applies, like comment or let me know if you have a similar experience or feeling like you've lost a bunch of weight or you know somebody's lost a bunch of weight, but they still won't go in certain things or do certain things because they're in their mind, they're still the same size or the same person that they were before. So I don't know, just, this is it. I said I would share it and I did. But yeah, so like I kept this outfit because I do have a picture of me wearing it at Universal. And if we can hunt down that picture, the whole reason why I picked that outfit because of that picture is that we usually keep all of our theme park pictures. And if we can find that picture, we'll slip it in so you can actually see me in the outfit to get a better idea of like the size I was before. That's not beauty face. I put my face on. I wonder if this camera even has like a beauty face kind of filter. I know my iPhone doesn't. If it does, I can't figure out. It's probably got something, but I don't know how to do it. I just wanted to say like hello, goodbye. I'm like all like dressed up for work. Since my hair has been the topic of the last couple of days, it's combed like just flat and back because I'm gonna wear a hat to work tonight, so I'm not really worried about what it looks like. But anything to say? Courtney's so tired. Look at him just laying there. Right now, yesterday's video is rendering. Oh, it's not showing nothing. Because I switched to the camera. Oh, I just like shined a light into the bathroom where I have a bag of trash sitting there. Anyway, so Courtney mentioned that I should go back to what I was doing earlier where I was like saying goodbye in the language of various countries. I don't remember where I was. I'd have to go back to the last video and take a look and see, but maybe I'll start doing that again. I don't really have anything else to say. Really boring people we are. The whole point of this vlog was to not be boring people, and it hasn't really changed much. So we need to work on that. Bye.